Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Love you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you for all the wonderful times that you have given to us. Thank you for these beautiful moments that we are going to have, Jesus. We are your little children, always waiting to have more and more experience with you, Lord. Our lives belong to you, Lord. Until we are with you, we have no fear, Lord, because you are the one who is protecting us. You are the one who is guarding us. You are the one who is the great master going to take control of our life. Thus, in order to attune to the teachings of the Lord, let us first listen to the scripture reading that is taken from Psalm number 91, verses 4 to 6. He will cover you with his pinions, and under his wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness is a shield and buckler. You will not fear the terror of the night, or the arrow that flies by day, or the pestilence that stalks in darkness, or the destruction that wastes at noonday. My dear brothers, sisters, and my dear children, during the first phase of the corona pandemic, I wanted to visit my mother and spend a few days with her. So I went along to my house, and when I reached, my mother was there, and I told her I will be staying for 8 days, and she was very happy. For the first day, it went on well. The second day, I went to my parish church, just had a private mass along with my parish priest, and came back, and I was just sitting at home. Toward the evening, I felt a lot of irritation about what is happening around because of this COVID-19. And on the third day, as I was there, I was not so happy. Certain things were disturbing me. In the evening, I went to have a shower. When I was having a shower, I felt a terrible fear within me, the fear of corona. And I felt something is not well with me. I was almost trembling. And at this time, I said, why all this are happening? But I did not have any answer for that. And I had my shower, came out, and remained in the house that night. Next morning, I thought it is good for me to go back to my friary in Mangalore, where the Divine Mercy Retreat Center is existing. And next early morning, I started. In spite of the hurdles of the lockdown, I reached our Divine Mercy Retreat Center. When I came there, I had directly asked, let me conduct the adoration part of it for the online streaming. And when I stood very close to the Lord, the Eucharistic Lord spoke to me. And that time I realized it was the low immunity power spiritually has completely shaken me. And I could make out during that time, I was a little scared because the spiritual power within me was not strengthening me, rather remaining in the house. It was slowly becoming less and less. Thus, I did not get that courage to remain longer. From that day onwards, when I sat back and looked, I came to know in the friary and in Divine Mercy Retreat Center, because of the lot of prayer hours, because of the Eucharistic celebration, because of the Holy Hour, because of the Divine Mercy Rosary, and all this, and the office hours, all this has completely strengthened us with the spirituality and spiritual power. During that time, I completely surrender myself to the Lord. I sat back and said, oh Lord, my spiritual power has lessened because I was not in direct connection with you. Today the world is still under corona threat. Many aspects added spices to the threat of corona and fear psychosis. The fear psychosis increased day by day. Various types of home remedies, the tonics, the Ayurvedic tablets, people started taking them in order to increase their bodily immunity. Corona, completely to remove, it is not in our hands. But to increase the bodily immunity, people took up lot of remedies. But if you look at in a spiritual world, we need to increase the immunity of our inner self. If we increase the immunity of our inner self, then we will be away from this fear. How will we increase the immunity of our inner self or our soul and body? It is through the Word of God. Word of God is a great appetizer. It increases our inner immunity. Let us read John's Gospel chapter 1 verses 1 to 4 and see what God has for us and what St. John's Gospel is telling us. If we read this, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through Him, and without Him not one thing came into being. What has come into being in Him was life, and that life was the light of all people. Beautiful words. The Word was life, and it is explained in Hindi in a much better translation way. And in Hindi it says, Adi mein shabd tha, shabd Ishwar ke saath tha, it was with God. And the third word is very, very meaningful, shabd Ishwari tha. That means Word itself was God, or Word Himself was God. The Word is the beginning of everything. Therefore, it is life. And this Word penetrates into our marrow, into our veins, into our bones, into our flesh, and into our heart. Therefore, Word of God is a double-edged sword which penetrates in the mind, the heart, and the soul. And the Word of God is very, very powerful because it has life in it. And therefore, we always say, when we read the Word of God, the Word becomes flesh in us. The Word becomes flesh in us because when we read the Word of God, it is the spiritual food which gives immunity to us. And the Word itself becomes flesh. And that is the spiritual food that we are having. And that gives power to my body and to my soul. Thus, I am able to become stronger in my spiritual life. My inbuilt capacity gets strengthened. It increases day by day. Thus, I become more powerful. When the Word becomes flesh in us, we get power to fight against the sins. The sinning ways are less and lessened. Thus, we become more pure. We fight against the Satan, and we fight against every disease that is attacking us. So, by the Word becoming flesh in us, it is like an antibiotic. So, it doesn't allow any disease to curb our strength. It increases our energy and it strengthens us. To be a healthy disciple of Christ, feeding on God's Word must be your first priority. The Word of God should be our first priority. The Word of God gives us the energy and the strength. Therefore, my first priority goes to the Word of God. Jesus called it abiding. In St. John's Gospel, Jesus calls it abiding. Especially in the 6th chapter and the 15th chapter, he says abiding. He said, if you abide in me, you will become truly my disciples. If you abide in me, you are truly my disciples. God's Word is the spiritual nourishment that will fulfill your purpose. Our purpose in this world is to build up that great relationship with the Lord, to go closer to Him, day by day become a spiritual being and trying to become like Him, that Jesus himself lives in us and me being a spiritual being. That is the great purpose, and that purpose is achieved only through the spiritual nourishment. The Bible is called our milk, our bread, our solid food, our sweet desert. This four course meal is the Spirit's menu for our spiritual nourishment and spiritual strength and spiritual growth. This is what very, very important for us. That is Bible, the milk, the bread, the solid food, as well as sweet dessert. If you see in the life of the child, this is very well followed. The child is fed with the milk, then later little with the bread, later solid food, and at last the sweet dessert goes. That is the way we need to go with the Bible. So we read the Bible, we try to assimilate it, we try to understand it, we masticate the words within ourselves, thus we become completely overtaken by the word. Saint Peter advises us, crave pure spiritual milk so that by it you may grow up in your salvation. By it you may grow up in your salvation. This is what Saint Peter is telling us. Wisdom, the book of wisdom, chapter 16, verse 12. For neither herb nor poultice cured them, but it was your word that heals all the people. You see, the herbs are not curing, not any of the medicines. Rather, it is the word of God that cures every sickness. In the same way, the Matthew's Gospel, St. Matthew's Gospel, chapter 8, verses 5 to 13, we see the episode of the centurion. The centurion was not a Jew, he was a Roman. And this centurion came to Jesus and pleading with Jesus, saying that, you cure my servant. And Jesus says, I'm ready to come to your house. At that moment, centurion being a Roman, he tells Jesus, your one word is enough. Say a word and my servant will be healed. What a great faith this centurion is having in Jesus. Therefore, Jesus hails and amazes the faith of a centurion. A centurion, usually, he will never bend for a Jew. Rather, he is supposed to call Master, Lord, as only a Roman, especially Caesar. But here, centurion knew the authority of Jesus. Jesus being a Jew has a great authority. Centurion has heard it, that Jesus has calmed the sea, he has silenced the wind, he has overthrown the leprosy, he had power over the paralysis, he has power over everybody, and therefore centurion knew the authority of Jesus. Therefore he says, say a word, Master, Lord, say a word, and my servant will be healed. It is beautifully narrated. Our food is the word of God. Our food of nourishment to get more immunity, to become stronger within ourselves, we require the word of God. Therefore it is said, the Spirit of God uses the word of God to make us like Son of God. What a rich theology. The Spirit of God uses the word of God to make us sons and daughters of God. In the book of Job, if you see, chapter 12, verse 10. Innocent is the life of every living thing and the breath of every human being. In his hand is the life of every living being. It is in the hands of God. Therefore, the word was a life, gives life to every being. And breath of every human being, even the breath that is of God's. Therefore, whatever we are, we increase our immunity because his word dwells in us. Immunize yourself with the spiritual power. The psalmist says, Psalm 19:7, the law of the Lord is perfect, reviving the soul. You see, every soul will be revived with the Lord's law. God can revive every soul. Therefore, even at the deathbed, we pray to the Lord, Lord, give them the strength that the death may go away and give them life. And this is our belief. And this belief has come because of the word of God. Because of the word of God, wherever Jesus went, when he raised Lazarus, he said, I am the life. I am the life. I am the truth. I am the way. And I am the resurrection. This is what is very, very important for us to imbibe in our day-to-day life. Thus, inbuilt with the power of the word, I stand firm. I stand firm. I don't have fear of anything, the external activities. I don't fear for the external entities. Rather, inbuilt with the power of the Lord, I stand firm. Having maintained strong spiritual intimacy, now let us sanitize ourselves with the precious blood of Christ. During this pandemic lockdown, one day I just went to visit one of my friends, and in the evening we were just talking about, and he said, Father, do you know, this pandemic somehow has given us more life, and the spiritual life has been completely revived. And I told him, how do you say this? Then he said, if you go and see the calendar or the book in the municipality or the corporation, the death rate this year is very low, because he is a daily user or a reader of the newspaper, and in the homage column he says, very few people of ours have been dead this year. And that time I asked him, you say this, but do you have any proof for that? Then he said, Father, I don't require much proof to give, but I tell you with my knowledge, this year the death rate is very low. It is because during this lockdown or during this corona pandemic, many people did not indulge in activities recklessly. Many people, especially the elderly, did not go out for the parties or for the gatherings and did not spoil their health. Many did not travel, therefore the accidents were very less. Many even did not get awareness that they are having certain sicknesses, therefore they remained quiet. And more than that, he said, more than that, this year, because of this corona pandemic and the churches did not have access for the people to come for the worship, more and more online masses, online holy hours, online teachings, online novenas, online praise and worship songs, online spiritual material was plenty, and people watching it, they grew spiritually. And when they grew spiritually, the immunity increased within themselves. Thus, every word that they saw and they read and everything that they grasped has become a benevolence for them. Therefore, these people did not mind the sickness much. Rather, they depended fully on the Lord. And this is a very good finding. Then he told me, Father, this is a very nice thing I see in my own life. I experience, my old mother is there. She's also watching and she's so cheerful, so happy because of the spiritual power which is there in her. My dear brothers and sisters, though corona pandemic has disturbed us in various ways, many of us have grown in our spiritual life. Many of us have that ardent faith, and we have grown in our trust in the Lord, thus making our every bit of our life very closer to the Lord. Having maintained strong spiritual intimacy, we are with Christ, we are sanitized with his blood. If you see St. John's Gospel chapter 6, verses 56 and 57, we will just see it, verses 56 and 57. They read like this. Those who eat my flesh and drink my blood abide in me and I in them. Just as the living Father sent me, I live because of the Father. So whoever eats me will live because of me. Very, very wonderful words of Jesus. Whoever eats me will live because of me. One who eats my flesh and drinks my blood will live with me and I live in him. And those who eat the flesh of Christ, they really have that great power. Therefore, we as human beings and as the children of Christ are sanitized with his blood. First letter of Saint Peter, chapter 1, verses 18 and 19, it says like this: You are not ransomed by gold and silver, but with the precious blood of Christ. Unblemished blood. You are not ransomed gold and silver, the earthly materials. Rather, you are ransomed or cleansed with the precious blood of Christ. These days, you will see sanitizers everywhere. Different type of sanitizers. Some different odors and some are having different colors. This way, many people are so much using those sanitizers. It has become a practice these days everywhere, going and taking the sanitizers and rubbing the hands. And again, after coming back, again, we use the sanitizer. It has become an external practice for most of us. And it is also a precaution from this corona pandemic. For our internal life, we use the blood of Christ as the sanitizer. For internal life, it has to be purified. We cannot drink this external sanitizer for purification. Rather, we clean our internal self with the blood of Christ. In St. John's Gospel, chapter 3, verse 16, it is beautifully said, God so loved the world, God so loved the world that he gave his only son for the salvation of mankind. One who believes in him will have eternal life. Will have eternal life. God loved us so much. He gave his only son. His only son was so dear to him. But for the love of every human person, he gave his only son. And one who believes in him will have eternal life. Therefore, during this corona pandemic or any other sicknesses or problems or tribulations, we need not to worry, because if we believe in Christ, he will take care of us. And he says, you will have eternal life. Eucharist is the sanitizer of our life, and sacrament of reconciliation cleanses our inner self. Therefore, during this lockdown and when it was unlocked, many people came and they pleaded for confession. We want to have confession because their inner self was suffering without that real spiritual strength. And they wanted to have that growth because they wanted to cleanse themselves. And they said, after the confession, we felt so happy. As Word was life in the beginning, the expiation of blood from the cross gives life to all of us. The expiation of Christ's blood from that cross, every drop of blood that gives us life. The Word and the body and the blood of Christ gives us spiritual nourishment. This is what we need to understand. The spiritual nourishment does not come from somewhere else. It is because of the Word that became flesh in us, and because of the bread, the body and blood of Christ that strengthens us. Therefore, many were seeking to have the communion. They wanted to receive the Holy Eucharist and they said, we want the communion. And this is where people felt the thirst, the need. They were hungry for the food. Thus, they wanted to sanitize themselves. They wanted to grow spiritually in this matter. When we are spiritually sanitized, the entire being becomes the abode of the Holy Spirit. The entire being becomes the abode of the Holy Spirit. The Spirit dwells in us. Very powerfully the Spirit dwells in us. That's why St. Paul, in a letter to the Romans, chapter 8, verse 10, he says, but if Christ is in you, though the body is dead because of the sin, the Spirit is alive because of righteousness. So the body is dead because of sin. When we sin, the body is dead. But thus, because of the Spirit, we rise again. And that is what he says. There is righteousness and there is life. The Spirit gives life to us. 1 Corinthians chapter 3 verse 16. Saint Paul beautifully once again tells that you are God's temple and God's Spirit dwells in you. What a beautiful thing. Such a beautiful thing. When we sanitize ourselves through the great sacraments of reconciliation and Eucharist, the Spirit gets entry and the Spirit gets the dwelling within ourselves because we are purified. We are purified with the blood of Christ, and thus how externally we purify our hands with the sanitizers, in the same way internally the blood of Christ cleanses us and we are purified. Therefore Saint Paul says, you are the temple, and you are that temple, and that temple is holy. That temple is holy. So with Saint Paul we can say, the one who is inside me is much stronger than the enemy outside. The one who is inside me, the Holy Spirit, is dwelling in us. He dwells in us because when we are sanitized with Christ's food and the word, we are completely belonging to Him. Therefore, Jesus says, as my Father is holy, you have to become holy. My Father is so holy and you want to become holy. That is what it is said. When we become sons and daughters of God, we become very holy and the entire Spirit lives in us. In Revelation chapter 12 verse 11, it is read like this. We live by His blood and we are sanitized with the sacrament of reconciliation. We live by His blood. Very well, the Revelation says, live by His blood, by Christ's blood. And that is what giving us the spiritual strength and the spiritual energy. Therefore, we are sanitized with the sacrament of reconciliation and the Eucharist. My dear brothers and sisters, COVID-19 has taught us to sanitize our life with His blood. As the external sanitizers are cleansing the external part of our body, the internal part is completely nourished. It is completely energized and is spiritualized because we sanitize our body with His blood. Thus, Eucharist has a great meaning for us. Therefore, without Eucharist, our life is dry. Without Eucharist, we are filled with fear and trembling. But when Jesus Himself dwells in us and Himself makes His home in us, when the Holy Spirit makes His abode in us, we are strengthened and we can stand without any fear. Whatever it may be, the corona has taught us certain lessons to depend completely with the Lord. Our trust is with the Lord. Therefore, most of the time, when we are frightened, we ran back to the Lord and said, we are there. Some of them drifted. Many cases came to me. The parents came and said, my daughter is behaving differently. My son is losing his mental balance and they got addicted. It is because they were not focusing on the word of God and they did not sanitize their life with the spiritual nourishment. Most of them, though there were online masses, some of them did not want to see. They drifted away and thus their life became a life of addiction. And some got into psychological disorders. They came and they said, Father, everything was okay. After the lockdown, my child, my daughter, my son got into this disease. It is because, again, we failed to sanitize our soul and our inner self. We sanitized, we were perfectly well outside externally. We followed all the rules and regulations. But internally, we did not follow those rules and did not make our life virtuous. We did not play the virtues in our life. Rather, certain vices, maybe the addiction for the phone or maybe addiction for some other things, or we felt very lonely and we took it like a depression and went away and we drifted away. Thus, we did not remain with the Lord. And when we are not with the Lord, like the disciples in the boat, when Jesus was sleeping, they were drowning. And that time they said, oh Lord, you're sleeping. They woke Him up and they said, we are drowning and we are perishing. And that time Jesus says, calms the wind and the sea, and he says, you men of little faith, why did you get frightened? The same thing Jesus is asking us today. If you have that close relationship with the Lord, we will be beautifully putting up our life and becoming stronger. In order to keep distance, we call it a social distance. What type of distance we need to keep? We maintain that social distance as it is, but in spirituality, to keep the distance from all the addiction and all the evils, all the satanic ways, all the sinful ways, we need to keep that distance from all this addiction, from the evil inclinations, and close our mouth from all the gossip, from all the ills, from the lies, and from the bad words, and all the bad spoken language. We need to put a nice mask and remain. Therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, the COVID-19 pandemic, for some, it has become a real threat. For some, it is a time to go closer to the Lord, depend on Him, increase our immunity with the Word of God, with the flesh that lived in us, and also sanitize ourselves with the precious body and blood of Christ. When it was not available because of the lockdown, we also had the spiritual communion, and there many people got strengthened. And today, in some of the places of the world, the churches are open. We go and become one with the Lord, and thus we become strengthened person. The fact that when I went home for 3 days, there's no more remaining in me. Therefore, I, during the pandemic, did a lot of work, went around, celebrated masses, met the sick people, listened to their confessions, blessed over them, prayed over them, and thus made their life little more alive and active. I remember a case I would like to share with you. During this pandemic, during the second lockdown, one of the lady called me and said, Father, please come to my house because I am suffering with cancer and it has increased. I don't know how many days I am living. Then I said, I don't know you. Therefore, I'll tell you, I don't know whether I'll be able to come there. But she pleaded and said, Father, please come. Usually when people meet me, after I study the history, then immediately I go. But here, I said, okay, since you're suffering with cancer, I will come. I took my intercessory people, and along with them, I went to her house. And it was a very interior place. And again, we kept the vehicle and we walked in the field. When I entered her house, right, she was standing near the doorstep. I said, I would like to meet you personally for a few minutes. And we went inside. As I was talking to her, she said, Father, I am really suffering. I do not know whom to tell. Father, there is a satanic cult practice in our family. In all the four houses, all the four houses of the brothers, and all the four houses, this practice is going on for the past 60 years. I was surprised. I said, my dear woman, why for the past 60 years you did not tell anyone? She said, we could not say to anybody because the eldest member of the family said, you should not say to anyone. And I kept quiet, Father. Now, I don't know how long I am living, Father. Therefore, I have to tell you. Therefore, I am telling you, Father, there is a certain satanic cult thing is tied on top of the roof. And he told me, by the time I said, why all this? And she also was very much sad about it, and she said, no one listens to me, Father. By the time I just taught to the entire life for the 60 years how these people are living, and by the time I told her what to do now, then she said, Father, at least remove from my house and give me. I am not forcing them. But I said, if I remove from your house, it's also we should remove from their house, because it's all combined, the relative's house. And that time she said, Father, I don't think they will listen, because many people told them to remove it. Many spiritual people came to the house and told them to remove it. They did not agree. They said, it's not possible. It is practice from the long years onwards. Then I said, call them. By the time she said, Father, don't tell them that I told you all this. I said, don't worry about it. And as they came inside, I asked my Lord, my Lord, what to do? How to go about? And my Lord gave me the same St. John's Gospel chapter 6. If you eat my flesh and drink my blood, you will live in me and I live in you. So I questioned them with two, three sentences. You belong to whom? They said, we belong to Christ because we practice Catholicism. We have the sacrament of reconciliation. We are already baptized and we have the Eucharistic celebration. We receive communion. And that time I questioned them, why all this? They said, it was done from a long time onwards. Our forefathers did it, so we practiced it. So I told them, no, we cannot do it. It has to be removed. Then immediately they said, Father, if you are willing to remove, we are ready. But then they wanted me to climb the inner roof and remove it because they have tied on top of it. By the time I said, one of you should climb the roof and I will bless it from here and nullify the energy. And I said, I prayed over and I asked the Lord to nullify everything. And meanwhile, the person went, he removed it and brought. The second house, when I went there, the same problem. Again, that person says, whether to remove or not to remove. I said, once we agreed upon, you have to remove. Then all the four houses, we removed it. And all that things which are there tied in the roof, we got it together. We kept it. By the time they started telling me, Father, there are two stones of the Satan in our land. What to do? Then I said, okay, again, we will pray over and nullify the energy. And now you come and have the confession. After the confession, we had a beautiful, glorious liturgy. There were 22 people having singing and very happy about it. And I also felt so happy. And after that blessing, everything, the Eucharistic celebration was over. I told them, now you need to throw those things. And they came along with me. There was a flowing water and we threw in that and they got relieved. And that lady, after 1 month, she expired. Before her expiry, she said to her daughter, now I'm a relieved person because I was stain of sin, the practice of other cult, but now I'm so happy because now I'm washed with the blood of Christ and my entire family has been redeemed. Redeemed. Every relative is happy today. Then after her burial and month's mind mass, everybody was saying, it is because of her we are relieved, we are redeemed. See, such a beautiful way of the precious blood and body of Christ could work wonders. Work wonders. And this lady saying it, I am cleansed with this blood. And during pandemic, I had a great chance to have that communion. And therefore, I am very close to the Lord. Let the Lord call me. And definitely, the Lord has taken her and all the good works he has done surely yield good place in heaven. My dear brothers and sisters and dear children, we spiritually, when we become strong, God takes care of us. It is not our plans that we do. We need to sanitize ourselves completely with his strength, with his spirit. Then Jesus himself will lead us. That's why in St. John's Gospel, chapter 15, verse 7, he says, if you abide in me, you will bear much fruit. And again, in St. John's Gospel, chapter 10, verse 10, the second part of it, he said, I have come that you may have life and life in abundance. Life in abundance. That abundance of life Christ has come to give us. Though there are certain difficulties, certain shortcomings during this corona pandemic, many are suffering. Let us pray for all of them. Let's take a minute of silence, thus praying for every soul who has gone because of this corona pandemic. And those who are suffering on deathbed, in the hospitals, in the houses, in isolation, in quarantine, let us pray for them. Let us close our eyes. Loving Father, we, your loving children, sanitize with your body and blood. You have given us the great strength by imbibing your word in us. Thus expiating your very blood, you have given us a lot of strength. Today, in a very special way, I pray for all the COVID-19 pandemic patients, all those who are suffering, all those who are in the deathbed, Lord, though the death is coming very closer to their bed, send it back as you have given life for those who are dead. Instill life in every patient who is struggling for life. Extend your hand to all those who are having difficulties, all those who are in fear, and all the families who are undergoing the isolation. Lord, be with everyone. Give the eternal rest all those who are dead and gone before us due to this pandemic. Let God be their strength in heaven and on earth. Let God strengthen us day by day. Thus, we may remain always closer to Him, immunized with great energy, that immunity of His word made flesh in us, thus making us more powerful instrument of His kingdom. Amen.